Okay, so for the twist and turn lesson plan, we're going to start on the balance beam. And we're going to start, for the kids who are able to, they're going to try to walk sideways and forwards. And they're going to cover the frog's eyes with their toes. Don't let them see you. Peekaboo. And the kids that are less advanced, if you want to, you can just have them feed the frog some bugs if they can't do that. Continuing on with the kids who are more advanced, they will try to do a backwards jump, safety stop, off the beam. Then the kids who are less advanced, like the parents hot and maybe some threes, will just walk down the balance beam and jump open on the numbers. But the kids who are more advanced, we're gonna add a little bit to that. So they'll jump open on the number and then do a froggy jump back up and then jump open on the number and jump like a froggy back up. Then we're gonna be snakes. And the snakes are gonna go all around the cones. Then we're gonna come to the scooter and we're gonna sit on the scooter. Make sure to set it up so that the handles are facing forward and they put their feet on the handle in the front and they scooch forward using their body. Make sure to set it up so that there's a block at the front and the end so that the scooter and the parallel bars don't move. Then they're gonna go up the steps and they're gonna be a big airplane, vroom, vroom, and you're gonna jump your airplane into the ocean. And we're gonna do one more jump safety step before we come back. Okay, so in the first circuit, one modification that you can make is you can have the students crawl around the cones if you want to instead of running. This might be a better option, especially if the kids can do it because it's eye tracking and all of that. So you can put some paw prints out as a marker. So that's the first circuit. For the back of the room, over here on the pink wedge, they'll do their forward roll. So they'll stand on top, up so tall, down so small, roll like a ball. Kids who have good forward rolls, you can have them start on the blue mat. Over here by the P-bars, they're going to close the frog's eyes and they're going to alternate forwards, sideways, forwards, sideways, so they learn a little bit about turning. Then they're going to come crawl through the tunnel. Don't touch the sides. Make sure to stay really small. And they're going to come do their airplane again, so they'll put their feet on the rocks, look for the flowers and pick up one foot, and they can try to pick up the other foot if they're four. And then they can come to the first bar and they're going to put their hands sideways on the bar. You're going to need to explain to them sideways hands. And then they're going to walk their feet up and do a little koala where they can just hold their feet on the red mat and swing. You want to show us that, Malka? Just putting their feet on the mat. For three-year-olds, that it will probably be enough. Then on the next bar, again, they're going to put their hands sideways on the bar and they're going to kick one balloon and then turn and kick the other balloon. And then they're going to do one more time over here. They're going to put their hands on the bar and they're going to sit on one of the alligators. Hi, alligator, and swing. And then they're going to put their hands back straight and put their feet on the next alligator and swing. Over here on the trampoline, they're going to have their hands up high and they're literally going to just jump in a circle. Jump in a circle, and they don't have to like do a full twist. They can, you know, do it however they want to do it. And then they're gonna do a safety stop at the end. For the transitions, if you wanna come to the middle, Coach Malka, the first transition should be safety stop, especially if you haven't done it yet in your classes. So you can do bounce, bounce, freeze, bend your knees. And then you can do a few bounce, bounce, freeze, bend your knees, put your arms out, and you can high five them. So that should be the first transition. And then for the second transition, you can either do, talk about their sideways hands for the bars. Let's see with that. So they can either do their sideways hands for the bars. You want to show us, Coach Malka? Right, and have practice having them switch. Or you can have them do the airplane song, which I'll try to send in a separate video. So just having them all stand up on the line and you'll be in the front and you'll do the airplane song with them, and then they'll go into the second circuit. If you do wanna do the hands, then you can do the airplane song at the end to finish class. And that's it.